guys. It's Michelle Ochoa, aka Aura. I wanted to invite you to do a sun gazing chakra cleansing meditation with me. Okay, so if it's your first time, it's about sunset. Still a little bright over here on the west coast. So get your shades and come back and join me. Find a comfy spot. And I'm over here in like a park by a trail, so there's somebody coming up, so don't worry about any interference. So what we're gonna do is put on your shades and get comfortable, right? And so sun gazing, I know they tell us like, don't look at the sun, it'll hurt your eyes.
Hello.
Hi. Oh, you've even got the cat with you. Yep. How cute is that?
He has to go too.
Oh, so beautiful way. White kitty. Do you mind if I show the kitty on my video? It's like a meditation video.
His name's Larry Bird.
Oh, Larry Bird. So sweet. Hi. Furry friend. Furry friend. Such a beautiful day, right?
Yes, thank you.
Hi, baby. Go. Go with mommy. Oh, so sweet. All right, so find a comfy spot outside. Oh my god, the cat's gorgeous. I don't know if I have the camera right. It's like all white. So anyway, yeah. So find a comfy spot to get your shades on, sun gazing. I know we've been told, like, you know, don't look at the sun. It's bad for you. Like, rethink everything you've ever learned, I swear. It isn't that comfortable. It'll be okay. And have an intention in mind that you want to focus on. Yes, we're going to do a chakra cleansing of the chakras. But also, as we're staring into the sun with shades, unless you're used to sun gazing, you may not need them or your eyes aren't as sensitive as, like, mine. Something that you desire to do or to have, I want you to come from a pure place of your heart. And as you're staring into the sun, we're going to hold that thought, and we're going to visualize ourselves doing it so that we can manifest it with the creation energy of the sun and with our own heart space. Okay, the sun rules the heart space. In astrology, it's the sign of Leo, which is the heart space and the fixed flame of inspiration. And it's just such a powerful light source. It is the light that gives everything life. So we're going to give ourselves life and light and bring life to our creations and to our projects. Everything starts with an idea, right? And visualization is very powerful. So, ready? First time, it may feel weird to stare at the sun, and just trust it's okay. You'll notice it'll start to reflect a bit. I like to start with gratitude towards the sun for all that it gives us, pushing it from my heart space. How much you love the sun and everything it provides for us, the warmth, the vegetation of eating fruits and veggies, the beautiful surroundings of nature. I just want to ask spirit, light, fill our bodies through the windows of the soul with light, cast the light on all of our shadows. Deep breaths in through the nose and out through the mouth. And this is where we want to do the visualization of something you are going to create. Go ahead and hold the vision of that in your mind. attach people and places to it. You know, like if it's something you're creating for other people, attach the happiness you feel when they receive it, or that they feel when they receive it, whatever it is, how happy you feel when you receive whatever it is, or when you create and do the things. And just focus on one thing. We can have many projects we want to do, which is like always my problem. And just keep doing those deep breaths as you visualize. Take as long as you need on this part. You can go through all the many steps that it'll take. Visualize yourself taking the steps and it being successful. I have this habit of playing thoughts in my head as I'm doing the intentions, describing it, which I don't think is bad because it's our thoughts, but I constantly am trying to work, well, not constantly, because I just started really understanding that we have to detach from the mind and visualize and feel more, and so that's what it's about. So if you start playing like the words of, and this is happening, to help yourself visualize it, it's fine as long as you start to visualize. And then feel the emotions of it, and that really draws the energy to us. If you have activated your third eye, either way, staring into the sun, it's really neat because you get these ancient Egyptian symbols like I do. Sun gaze after your third eye opens. I don't know if that's the same for everyone. I'd be interested to see what your experience is. So again, we're trying to quiet the mind of the thoughts of describing the situation and actually tapping into how it makes us feel for this creation to be successful. If you have trouble, like I do, with constantly separating the mind, going back to gratitude easily gets you back in the body. And what I mean by that is just feeling grateful, right? It's one of the highest vibes, like love. And you can go back to just being grateful for the sun or whatever it is that connects you to that heart energy. And you, as you practice this, you'll literally start to feel the heart space open up. You can measure heart energy coming from our heart. It's separate from the mind. this creation, this project, this intention, how satisfied your soul will feel, how empowered you will feel to create something of your own, right? And depending on what you're intending, and how much more confidence you'll have too, seeing it come to fruition. And feel this. Some time to do the chakra cleanse, the chakra meditation. I can't see. I want to see if the video is still going. I think it is. I need to clear space. All right, so we're going to. Oh my gosh, I'm sitting on this log. I might do like this. Be a little better for my posture. And so I would like us to sun gaze with this too, this meditation of, sorry if the wind is interfering with the sound, guys, I'll speak up. So we're going to do a chakra meditation, and we're going to call in and imagine the color red, which if you're sun gazing, you can start to see the auras of the sun, and it makes a rainbow, so it's usually on the outer part, and then it gets more purple on the inner. Some of the shoulders, the body. Make sure you're taking belly breaths. When you inhale through the nose, the belly rises, expands, and then when you exhale through the mouth, it deflates. Okay? That's to make sure we're not breathing from up here and we're doing actual belly breaths. And we're just going to imagine chakra spinning like a flower, which is located by the genital area, the root of the spine, and that is our security and ability to ground. And so picture the color red coming from the sun right to that root chakra. As heavy and grounded as you can in that energy. Think about what makes you feel secure, as that's the root chakra, representing home and security. Interesting info, Mount Shasta in California, Northern California, is the root chakra of the earth. And there's several, you know, there's seven chakras. I mean, there's like 12, but locations due to, I believe, ley lines throughout the earth and where these chakras are. I was having a discussion with a friend last week or something about these. It's really neat. I can't wait to travel all over to visit all the different chakras. And it's really cool that the home one is in California. Good to eat a rainbow diet. Beets are a good one for grounding. Cherries, raspberries, anything red. And it's a grounding energy that brings us back to earth. Ultimately, earth is our home. Nature. To the orange, the sacral. The sacral chakra is just under the navel and the womb area of creation. And so with everything going on in the world, we are learning, right? We're not just consumers, we're creators. We don't have to, you know, leave high school and all of a sudden we're adult and go to college and get married at this age and have kids and choose this one job and da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. Old stuff. No. We're creators. And the womb is where the sacral chakra is. It's a sacred place. And the color is orange. So from the sun, it's also your sexual energy. It's your creative energy. From the sun, we call in the color orange. And you just visualize the color orange coming to your sacral center. And we're going to ask it to heal any blockages to our creative energy. Any trauma to our womb from past sexual experiences, of childbirth, of anything that is interfering with our ability to use our power as a creator. And imagine a mandala flower of the orange sacral chakra turning. The chakras are energy centers. And so not only do we feel grounded from our root chakra, we pull in this orange, vibrant color. Co-creators. And of course you can eat some oranges, clementines, tangerines, apricots. Add orange to your diet, orange bell peppers. Cheetos? Don't think so. Now we're going to move into the solar plexus, which is about the rib space, I believe. And actually I think it's a little lower, about right here. Because that's where you feel like the nudge. And it's linked to having courage and to be inspired. And inspiration is so key. It's important to be inspired so we have that courage after we are grounded and we're ready to create. We've got to take the courage and stay inspired. And so we ask the sun to pull in that yellow, vibrant energy. That gold, that beautiful yellow gold, and heal any issues with being inspired, staying inspired, any blocks from being courageous and brave. Security, the orange creative, and now the yellow sacral, solar. Just imagine again the yellow light, yellow golden light from the sun charging and cleansing that solar plexus and the flower turning as it's activated. And then we move to the heart chakra, and the heart center is in the middle of the chest. You can feel it, sometimes it's a little more to the left. And it's the color green, like all of the vegetation on the earth. Love is vibrating from the space. And so we want to ask the sun to bring forth green light to clear. cleanse and charge our heart chakra to be able to love, to get rid of any blocks that we have created from the mind, from the past.
Are you good on time?
Cool. And pull in that green energy. Imagine it. Flower turning, that green light energy cleansing issues with love, which, let's be honest, we all have. We've been in an imbalance in this world of the sexes, of relationships, of so much shit. Let's set an intention as we pull in that green heart space energy to help us understand and embody unconditional love, green light, cleansing, balancing, and charging the heart space. As we move up to the throat chakra, this is a blue, and it represents stating our truth. Definitely struggle with this. I'd rather avoid confrontation all day long, work, business, love, whatever it is. I mean, certain things all, you know, it's perfectly easy, but a lot of us have this block as well, as we've been in a world where it's, you know, been a lot of fakery, like, how you doing? Fine. Like, I don't believe there's any truth in that. I mean, it's probably true, but, like, it's such an automatic response. And then, you know, all kind of societal stuff, so. And then conditioning and how you were raised, and if you were raised to be accepted for your voice, you know, a lot of children are hushed, you know. Marriages have been out of balance, so spouses, you know, become, like, controlling and, you know, and I make the decision, we don't do this together sort of thing. So we want to call in to the beautiful sun, the blue energy to heal the throat chakra, to balance it. So we imagine blue. It's turning, the flower is turning for the throat chakra. We ask for it to cleanse with blue light any fears on our voice and stating our truth, any blockages to being heard, any blockages to communicating. And we ask the sun to give us confidence in our communication. It activates this throat chakra. We imagine that blue light radiating to the throat center, flower turning. Then we move up to the third eye. And this one is an indigo color. And as we sun gaze, we allow the third eye to charge. We imagine the indigo color coming forth from the sun to decalcify the pineal gland, to charge the third eye, to allow us to connect to the light of the third eye that leads us by way of intuition. Indigo, indigo, cleanse the imbalance of the third eye as we're led by the light. And then we raise brings the awareness to the crown chakra, which is actually outside of us, just hovering above. This is where we'll get downloads, spiritual downloads. Angels may drop messages in, things like that, stuff from God, right? From spirit. It's the spiritual realm of things. It's purple. So we're going to ask the sun to send that beautiful purple energy to our crown chakra to cleanse, so that we may discern and determine what's coming in that's from the spiritual realm, from the highest light, and remove any blocks to being able to hear. And a deep breath. And so it is. And now we've done the chakra cleansing. And so from crown all the way down, we're going to imagine a white light of the sun and the protection of the light going through the crown of purple to the indigo third eye, to the voice of truth, to the heart of love and integrity, to the inspiring of green, to the inspiring yellow where we have courage like a lion, to the sacral chakra, the orange creative energy where life is born, where we give life to things, and to the root chakra of red where we're driven and our animal instincts are, and it's about survival and home. And as that white light runs through, we are a crystal of a rainbow. You know, it sounds foo-foo. Wait till your third eye opens, you're gonna really believe this shit. Thank you guys for joining me with that. I love you so much. And if you liked it, like it on YouTube, subscribe, share, all the things, and I'll see you soon.